Jesus, just to take him at his word, just to rest upon his promise, just to know, thus saith the Lord. Jesus, how I trust him, how I've proved him o'er and o'er. Jesus, precious Jesus, oh, for grace to trust him more. Trust him more. Trust him more. Trust him more.
I am resurrection and I am life, says the Lord. Whoever has faith in me shall have life, even though he die, and everyone who has life and has committed himself to me in faith shall never die. As for me, I know that my Redeemer lives, and that at the last he will stand upon the earth. After my awakening, he will raise me up, and in my body I shall see God. I myself shall see, and my eyes behold him, who is my friend and not a stranger. For none of us has life in himself, and none becomes his own master when he dies. For if we have life, we are alive in the Lord. And if we die, we die in the Lord. So then, whether we live or die, we are the Lord's possessions. Happy from now on are those who die in the Lord. So it is, says the Spirit, for their rest from their labors. We will now sing the hymn, He Lives.
I know that he is living, whatever. rejoice, O Christian, lift up your voice and sing. Sing a little hallelujah to Jesus Christ the King, the hope of all who seek Him, the help of all who cry. The Father rests so loving, so good and kind. He lives, Christ Jesus lives today. He walks with me and talks with me along my every way. He lives, salvation to empire. Yes, He is, I know He is. He lives in my heart.
Good morning, and thank you for joining us in the homegoing service for our brother, Dr. George Moore. Welcome to St. Sebastian by the Sea in Melbourne Beach. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. O God of grace and glory, we remember before you this day our brother George. We thank you for giving him to us, his family and friends, to know and to love as a companion on our earthly pilgrimage. In your boundless compassion, console us who mourn. Give us faith to see in death the gate of eternal life, so that in quiet confidence we may continue our course on earth, until by your call we are united with those who have gone before, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please sit for the ministry of the word, and we'll have Christopher, the grandson, to read our first lesson.
Let us now sing the praises of famous men, our ancestors and their generations. The Lord appointed them great glory, His majesty from the beginning. They were those who ruled in their kingdoms and made a name for themselves by their valor. Those who made counsel because they were intelligent, those who spoke in prophetic oracles, those who led the people by their counsels and by their knowledge of the people's lore, they were wise in their words and instructions. Those who composed musical tunes or put verses into writing, rich men endowed with their resources, living peacefully in their homes. All these were honored in their generations, and were the pride of their times. Some have left behind a name so that others declare their praise. But of others, there is no memory. They have perished as though they have never been existed. They have become as though they have never been born, and their children after them. But there were also godly men whose righteous deeds have not been forgotten. Their offspring will continue forever, and their glory will never be blotted out. Their bodies are buried in peace, but their names live on generation after generation. Word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
You'll now have the reading of Psalm 139 by Patty.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Psalm 139. 1 through 11. Lord, you have searched me out and know me. You know my sitting down and my rising up. You discern my thought from afar. You trace my journey and my resting places and are acquainted with all my ways. Indeed, there is not a word on my lips, but you, O Lord, now know it altogether. You press upon my behind and before, and lay your hand upon me. Such knowledge is too wonderful for me, to me. It is so high that I cannot attain to it. Where can I go then from your spirit? Where can I flee from your presence? If I climb up to heaven, you are there. If I make my grave my bed, you are there also. If I take the wings of the morning and dwell in the uttermost parts of the sea, even there your hand hold me fast, and your right hand will lead me fast. If I say, surely the darkness will cover me, and the light around me turn to night, darkness is not dark to you. The night is as bright as day. Darkness and light to you are both alike. Glory be to Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Our second reading from Revelation, Mike Edwards.
A reading from the book of Revelations. Then I saw another angel ascend from the rising of the sun with the seal of the living God, and he called out with a loud voice to the four angels who had been given power to harm earth and sea, saying, do not harm the earth or the sea or the trees till we have sealed the servants of our God upon their foreheads. And I heard the number of the sealed, 144,000 out of every tribe of the sons of Israel. After this I looked, and behold, a great multitude which no man could number, from every nation, from all tribes, and all peoples and tongues, standing before the throne and before the Lamb, clothed in white robes and palm branches in their hands, and crying out with a loud voice, salvation belongs to our God who sits upon the throne and to the Lamb. And all the angels stood round the throne and round the elders and the found living creatures, and they fell upon their faces before the throne and worshiped God, saying, amen, blessing and glory and wisdom and thanksgiving and honor and power and might be our God forever and ever. Amen. Then one of the elders addressed me, saying, who are these clothed with white robes, and whence have they come? And I said to him, sir, you know. And he said to me, these are they who have come out of the great tribulation. They have washed their robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb. Therefore, they are before the throne of God and service him day and night within his temple. And he who sits upon the thrones will shelter them with his presence. They shall hunger no more, neither thirst any more. The sun will not strike upon them, nor any scorching heat. For the lambs in the midst of the throne will be their shepherd, and he will guide them to springs of living water. And God will wipe away every tear from their eyes. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. We will stand and sing the hymn, How Great Thou Art.